It was a partly cloudy day today with a few light showers, a gorgeous sunrise greeting us this morning to welcome in the start of the working week. It was also fairly mild for April, hovering around 19 degrees at 6 a.m. We saw some light showers across our north and northwestern suburbs, generally though only a millimetre or two, reaching a top of 23 to 24 degrees across our western suburbs, including Penrith, Blacktown and Liverpool, 21 the top in Terry Hills, 23 in Gosford, the city and in Cronulla. We saw rain across the north coast as well as parts of the Illawarra today, 6 millimetres falling in Taree, 4 in Byron Bay and 3 millimetres in Kempsey and Lismore. Thick fog blanketing parts of the state, visibility dropping to 100 metres in Lismore, Mossvale, Cooma and Guyra. Then today we saw tops in the low to mid 20s across most of the state, 23 the top in Newcastle and in Wagga Wagga, 25 in Coffs Harbour and in Grafton. Tomorrow a high will continue to direct showers along the New South Wales coast while a cold front will cross southern WA. Let's take a look around the country tomorrow. A shower or two expected in Brisbane, 25 degrees. Some early fog on the way for Canberra, 22. It should be a mostly sunny day in Melbourne, 25 degrees. Blue skies in Hobart and in Adelaide, while the mild and wet day on the way for Perth, 18 degrees. We're expecting a few light showers tomorrow in the very northeast corner of the state, but otherwise it will be mainly dry. Heading for tops in the mid-20s, 24 for Albury, Mudgee, Newcastle and Grafton. Top of 26 on the way for Griffith, Dubbo and Narrabri. Sydney could see some early fog around during Anzac Day commemorations. Then that fog should clear to a dry and mostly fine day with light to moderate northeasterly winds. Heading for tops of 24 degrees right across our west, including Kellyville, Liverpool and Campbelltown. 22 on the way for Terry Hills and Cronulla, and the city is expecting a high of 24 degrees. Let's take a look ahead, and Wednesday will also be fine. A little cooler though, 23 degrees. Just a possible shower on Thursday with a top of 24. Mostly sunny on Friday, 26 degrees. Then showers will start to increase on Saturday with a top of 23 and a potentially very wet day on Sunday, bringing up to 35 millimetres of rain and a cooler 21 degrees. Overnight lows hovering around 14 to 15 degrees for most of the week. In our west, finer 24 on Wednesday, warming up to 26 degrees on Thursday. Friday, though, looking absolutely lovely, a sunny 28 degrees before showers move in across the weekend, possibly bringing up to 40 millimetres of rain over the 2 days, those showers lingering into next week, Pete.
Amber, thank you.
Hello again from the incredible and historic Victoria Barracks. We're here ahead of tomorrow's Anzac Day commemorations with the dawn service to take place across the road at the Shrine of Remembrance from 5:30. After the service concludes, you can pop over here for the gunfire breakfast. It'll be a little different for the public this year with veteran food trucks lined up along St Kilda Road. The gunfire name refers to the traditionally rum-laced coffee or tea that was served as a form of liquid courage at the start of the day for the soldiers. The cuppers will be minus alcohol tomorrow, but still comforting and warm. Now today, parts of Melbourne got off to a very foggy start with visibility dropping as low as 100 metres. After that, the sunshine helped push the city's temperature up to 24.9, almost 5 degrees above the April average. Most suburbs reached 24 or 25 degrees. Werribee went one higher with 26, and that was the top maximum across southern Victoria, where a number of places peaked at 24. A bit further north, Horsham also reached 26 after a chilly low of 6. Warm northerly winds and clear skies are being delivered by a high pressure system that's now over the Tasman Sea. It'll remain fairly stationary over the next couple of days, so Anzac Day will be very pleasant, a perfect day for all the commemorative events outside. May get quite warm in the sun though, so always make sure to look out for our old diggers and loved ones. For dawn services around the capitals, it's looking dry overall. Brisbane could get a spot or two in the early morning, but staying mild with a low of 18 degrees. Perth's expecting showers, but not until later in the day. And 7 degrees in Canberra should be the lowest minimum, so not too bad at all. Back home, it'll be a bit milder overnight with minimums mostly ranging from 8 to 12 degrees. Morning fog is likely through eastern districts, especially about the ranges and valleys. Then another beautiful sunny day with most places expecting to reach the mid-20s, up to 29 in the Mallee. Here in Melbourne, there's the chance of patchy fog about northeastern suburbs, but it'll be a lot clearer than this morning and it won't get as cold. Once again, 25 is looking like the lucky number around town. Geelong is also heading for 25 degrees and a top of 23 in Rosebud. In the city, climbing from a low of 13 up to 25 with gentle breezes. Looking further ahead, and Wednesday will be mostly sunny and 24. 23 Thursday with light showers and strengthening winds. Friday, a top of 22 before showers arrive late in the day. Then a coolish weekend, just 15 on Saturday with a shower or two, 18 Sunday and 19 next Monday. It'll be fine and mild for the dawn service tomorrow morning and a beautiful Anzac Day ahead, whatever your plans, Pete.
That sounds fantastic. Thank you, Lavinia.
Not great news there, Andrew. Showers will continue overnight. Now, computer models are indicating that the best chance of showers moving through will be around 4 a.m, so around the time of our dawn service. The raincoat, the umbrella, certainly needed for tomorrow morning. If you don't get wet, you will be lucky indeed. Showers are in the forecast for just about all of this week. Let's have a look at the radar, something we haven't seen a lot of late. Showers today pushed in from those very strong east to southeasterly winds. Probably the northern suburbs through the Sunshine Coast picking up slightly heavier falls. It was the Glasshouse Mountains today averaging that 5 to 10 millimetre range. On to temperatures now, and look, it was cooler than average for April. The winds hit 91 kilometres per hour at Cape Morton, 98k at Double Island Point. The highest temp, Gatton, 28 degrees, Ipswich, 27, Brizzy, 26, the Golden Sunshine Coast, 25. With the weather map, strong winds and showers, possible hail across southern WA. Strong onshore winds and plenty of moisture will deliver showers to most of eastern Queensland. Showers and storms across the far northern tropics. Interstate, looking at a cooler day in Perth with showers, mostly sunny and warm in Adelaide, Melbourne and Hobart. A little cloud in Canberra and Sydney. Darwin 33, Alice Springs 30. Queensland, a few showers for Cairns, Mackay, mostly sunny and high 20s for Gladstone and Rocky. Mostly sunny and low 30s inland for Mount Isa and Longreach. And looking fine for Bundaberg, a couple of showers though for Maryborough and Gympie. Here in the southeast, a partly cloudy day. Look, showers most likely in the morning. Southeasterly winds to 30 kilometres per hour. Overnight temperatures as low as 13 degrees inland, but daytime highs only reaching the mid 20s across all the suburbs. Moreton Bay, the southeasterlies, still 15 to 25 knots on the bay, a strong wind warning offshore and further north. Brisbane, morning showers easing to a partly cloudy day, gusty southeasterlies and a high of just 25 degrees. Your 7-day outlook, a few showers possible Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and across the weekend as daytime temperatures sit in the mid-20s. Ipswich, a possible light shower or two every day over the next week. Daytime temperatures mainly mid-20s. Saturday, the warmest day with 26. For the Gold Coast, scattered showers Wednesday and Thursday, a shower or two Friday, Saturday and Sunday, 25 degrees each day. For the Sunshine Coast, a few showers possible each day over the week, 25 degrees each day. It should warm up to about 27 degrees by Sunday, but prepare for some wet weather for tomorrow's dawn service. It will clear up a little bit by mid-morning, but it looks like a wet start to Anzac Day, guys.
We'll be ready for it, Gary. Thank you.
Thanks, Kate. An Anzac Day youth vigil taking place behind us here at Semaphore on what's turned out to be a very balmy, still evening. It's around 21 degrees in the city, and just on that in the city, you might have noticed a smoke haze this afternoon. That's because we've had a couple of burn-offs in the hills. So across the suburbs, temperature-wise, we started the day at around 11 degrees at Glenelg this morning before making a top of 27. Very warm, Elizabeth and Mawson Lakes both making 28 degrees today. Under those clear skies up north, we cracked the 30-degree mark at Ceduna and Roxby Downs and the high 20s for many other spots. Renmark and Murray Bridge both made 29 and the radar stayed clear. Tomorrow, our winds are still coming from the northeast, so that means another dose of warm, dry air flows, and that's what's bringing these, well, pretty much summery vibes at the moment. Interstate, Tasmanians can't believe their luck after witnessing an incredible aurora australis overnight, while in Melbourne and Sydney, we've been dealing with thick fog this morning. Clear skies and 21 degrees for Hobart tomorrow. Back in SA, and a few more places are creeping up into the 30s, like Port Augusta and Port Pirie. Then Maitland is headed for 28. The warmth is also filtering through along to Murray Bridge and Renmark, both of those towns once again going for 29 degrees. And in the southeast, Narracourt is expecting 27. On local waters tomorrow, north to northeasterly is about 10 knots, becoming east to southeasterly in the late afternoon. And it's a warm Anzac Day forecast, with dawn temperatures likely to be around the 16-17 degree mark before tops of 28 at Elizabeth and 27 at Marion. A 17 degree minimum at around dawn in the city before a top tomorrow of around 27 degrees. And the warm weather is continuing on Wednesday as well. In fact, we're going for 28 degrees on Wednesday. There is a change coming coming in. It will probably roll in Wednesday night. So we're looking at showers and maybe even a storm overnight Wednesday into Thursday morning. And that's when the temperature drop arrives. So by Thursday, we're back down to 23 degrees. By Friday, we're back into the high teens and looking to be a little bit showery on and off with temperatures in the high teens on the weekend. So make the most of the warmth for the next couple of days.
Yeah, incredible for tomorrow, Jessica. Thank you.
To the weather with Sherry, and how's it looking for tomorrow's dawn service?
Well, Mon, it will be chilly and potentially a bit wet as well, so make sure you take a brolly with you. The chill arrived today already. We managed to top just under 19 degrees, our coldest April day in 4 years. Now, looking ahead around the country, and it will be quite a moving dawn service in Canberra as a fog settles in over the city, down to a chilly 7 degrees overnight. Mild to start in Sydney, 14 the minimum, and a top of 24 degrees with partly cloudy conditions. Morning showers for Brisbane, but a warm low of 18 degrees. If we take a look to Perth now, there is a moderate chance of showers during the dawn service. The breeze will have dropped for a short time, but it will be extra chilly. It's getting down to 9 degrees, but will feel closer to 8 degrees. We could see 15 millimetres of rain land in the gauge, and a top of only 19 degrees, feeling more like 14. Showers easing before lunch on Wednesday, still on the cooler side though, a top of 21 degrees. Another cold front on Thursday will add a few millimetres to the gauge. A sunny end to the working week, a top of 20 degrees, and a few chilly mornings expected across the weekend. So it looks like warm days are through for a little while at least, Mon.